on the north coast of Africa, on the Mediterranean Sea. Libya is home to around 6 million people. It is Africa's third largest country by area. Last year, its GDP was nearly $82 billion, according to CIA figures. Much of its wealth comes from its vast energy resources. Libya has proven oil reserves of 48 billion barrels, making it one of the top 10 oil-rich countries in the world. And with estimated gas reserves of 1.5 trillion cubic metres, it's among the top 25 gas-rich countries. Consequences can be felt globally. Oil production has dropped significantly since the fall of Muammar Gaddafi, affecting Europe in particular. And within the region, the UN says Libya's unstable borders are helping to facilitate organised crime and terrorism, as well as drugs and arms smuggling. The former British ambassador to Libya is Oliver Miles. He joins us now live from Oxford. Thank you for joining us. That point that Nick was making really brings the point home, doesn't it, that the militia seem to be more powerful than the government, because they were the ones that managed to get the Prime Minister released.
Yes, this is a unique problem in Libya. I don't think anyone else has faced this. It arises from the fact that in the revolution in 2011, these militias were formed from young men who took up arms to fight against Gaddafi. They succeeded. They overthrew the regime of Gaddafi, and they feel that the state, that Libya owes them one now, quite understandably. And Libya hasn't really been able to honour that debt because they haven't had the resources, organisation or structure to do it. What's probably needed more than anything else is jobs for these young men, and there aren't any jobs. So there's a real serious problem there. These militias are not in revolt against the government, but nor are they under the government's control. They're in a kind of halfway position.
But in some parts of the country, they actually control things, don't they? For example, blockading the country's oil export terminals. So they are controlling parts of the country.
Well, I think you mustn't exaggerate that. They have been able to blockade, it's true, they blockaded oil production, and that was, I think, mainly because the people who were being charged with protecting the oil facilities were not being paid. And so they took the law into their own hands and said, well, until we're paid, we're not going to let any oil out. And that was more or less successfully negotiated, and now the oil production is recovering, although it's still below capacity. And there was a similar problem with water. For a brief few days, it looked as if Tripoli's water supply was going to be cut off because of a dispute about a completely unconnected matter. Some local militia took the law into their own hands again. And this affair of the Prime Minister is the latest and, in the international perspective, perhaps the most spectacular of these incidents. Although whether you can really say kidnapping a prime minister is worse than cutting off the water supply of your capital is a moot point.
And it didn't last very long, but it is, as you say, it's a symbolic moment, perhaps, in the power struggle. But how do you get all of the groups involved in government and rally behind the leader? Because every country does need a leader with some sense of authority.
Yes, well, the positive side is that since the revolution succeeded towards the end of 2011, at that time, the people who were representing the revolutionaries, insofar as anyone was, drew up a roadmap for constitutional development for the next 2 or 3 years, leading to elections and a fully democratic government system. And so far, they've stuck to that roadmap to a remarkable extent. So they've had two handovers of power between governments which were without violence, which is very unusual in the region. They've had an election which everybody, I think, accepted was as fair as it could possibly be in the circumstances. And so the present Libyan government has a mandate from a democratic mandate, which really none of its neighbours have, but they haven't got the power.
OK, Oliver Miles, thank you very much indeed for joining us from Oxford. Live.